Described and Captioned Media Program. In the classroom and online. DCMP.org.
Landmark Media presents The Heart of Florence.
In the late 14th century, a little boy is growing up in the alleyways of Florence. Everyone calls him Pippo, although his real name is Filippo. It's an exciting time. Florence is in its heyday. The city is one of the largest trading hubs in Europe. It's ruled by powerful guilds, the most wealthy of these being the Arte della Lana, or Wool Guild. Members had become trade magnates, responsible for arranging the weaving of sumptuous woolen cloth and its export across Europe. The city is bristling with new constructions, imposing churches and magnificent palaces. Near Pippo's house, too, vast brick walls are shooting up skywards. The tallest of them all, the walls of a new cathedral.
The cathedral walls appear in a virtual model.
Every day, Pippo passes the building site. His father, Ser Brunellesco, is a city dignitary, and Pippo dreams of one day becoming a famous master builder and completing the monumental construction.
The cathedral's layout appears, seen from overhead. Now, a map of central Florence.
The people of Florence have already been working on the new church for 80 years. The square where it's located has been a sacred district for many hundreds of years. In Roman times, it was actually situated on the outskirts of the town. In the 5th century, the first church within the city walls was built here, directly alongside the northern city gate, with a baptistry and bishop's palace in front. This formed what was known as the Asse Sacro, or Sacred Axis. Archaeologists excavated the foundation walls of the ancient church around 40 years ago, beneath the floor of today's cathedral. Their work revealed the remains of a typical late Roman basilica, adorned with wonderful mosaics.
A museum holds church relics.
It had been dedicated to the Saint Reparata, an early martyr from Palestine. The Church of Santa Reparata was renovated and modified several times over the course of the centuries. It was finally upgraded to a cathedral in the 12th century, after the bones of Saint Zenobius were brought here. He's venerated as the first Bishop of Florence and is to this day one of the city's patron saints, together with Reparata and John the Baptist.
A bronze bust of Saint Zenobius gleams. The bishop has a thin face and a flowing beard. He wears a mitre, a tall ornate hat with a pointed peak. In a virtual model, an eight-sided brick building stands near the cathedral.
In Roman times, the baptistry opposite Santa Reparata was smaller than the current building, but octagonal just as it is today.
The Described and Captioned Media Program provides services designed to benefit students who are blind, visually impaired, deaf, hard of hearing, and deafblind. These services include a library of free loan described and captioned educational media, a clearinghouse of information related to educational media access, a gateway to internet resources related to accessibility, and a center for training and evaluation of any service provider desiring to appear on the DCMP's approved lists of description and captioning service providers. There are no user registration or service fees. Visit the DCMP at dcmp.org. The DCMP is funded by the U.S. Department of Education and administered by the National Association of the Deaf.